In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. Back to your program, Treasures, and commenting on the first letter to Thessalonians. We ended with the fourth chapter, and we were speaking about the details of the last day, how Christ will come and what will happen to the believers who are still living on earth and for those who have fallen asleep. And St. Paul explained clearly that there is no advantage for anyone who's still living on earth, because all the dead people will rise up at that minute to enjoy celebrating the King coming for the kingdom of heaven. And we all, the believers who rose from dead or changed from their bodies to the glorified body, will be caught up in the clouds to be with the Christ forever, as given in the last verse of the fourth chapter. And thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, comfort one another with these words. The last chapter, chapter 5, but concerning the times and the seasons, brethren, you have no need that I should write to you. So the second question, not about the details of the last day, but when will he come? So concerning when question, everyone knows that no one knows. So he's saying concerning the times and the seasons, brethren, you have no need that I should write to you. For you yourself know perfectly that the day of the Lord so comes as a thief in the night. So the thief will never give you an appointment. So the second coming is like a thief. But the thief, you know, will come to those who are not in waiting. But for the waiting people, he is like coming like a bride to his groom. For when they say peace and safety, then sudden destruction comes upon them. For the people who will live on this land, they feel like this will never end and the earth will never vanish. And they do not believe in the word of God that he will come and there will be a new start for the kingdom of heaven, not the kingdom of earth. But the non-believers do not believe in this. So when they say peace, safety, all destruction will come in a second, never expected. As labor pains upon a pregnant woman. Yes, labor pains come suddenly, but actually for any pregnant woman, she is expecting to have this labor pain. So although it looks like a sudden action, but again, with the logic, we should expect it. So with the belief in God's word, we are expecting that God is coming any minute. So, but like the labor pains, again, it comes suddenly, and they shall not escape. But you, brethren, are not in darkness, so that this day should overtake you as a thief. So the idea of a thief is not suitable for the believers. It's the reality for the non-believers. This day will come like a thief for them. But for us, who are not living in darkness, we are living in the light of the Lord. So we are always waiting. We are expecting his coming. We are eager to see him. We, you know, love this and we hope for this. So because of our faith and hope, his second coming will be the best news for everyone who believe in him. You are all sons of light and sons of the day. We are not of the night nor of darkness. Therefore, let us not sleep. So by saying let's not sleep, it's not like you are not allowed to sleep. But not sleeping here means that do not sleep away from God. Do not sleep in darkness. Do not forget the good news. Just be alert. Be always faithful and waiting for Christ to come. So don't sleep like other who is sleeping peacefully as if this life will never end. That's a false peace. That's not a real peace, because the peace you have to have upon the real faith or the reality. Therefore, let's not sleep as others do, But let us watch and be sober. So by the commandment of watching, it's like you have to wait for God to come. You have to be alert. You have to watch for your life. Are you ready to see Christ any minute? Are you ready to stand before the judgment of the Lord? So you have to be watchful. And also by saying you are the sons of light, sons of the day, that there is no darkness in your life. You do not allow any dark ideas, any bad lusts in your life. You love everyone to live in a peaceful, lightful way. Because the light of God goes with the love of God. And in order to live and to walk in the light of God, it's all about to love God and love people all the time. For those who sleep at night, and those who get drunk are drunk at night. But let's who are of the day be sober, putting on the breastplate of faith and love. So again he's saying, be watchful, be sober, do not sleep like others, because the people of this world may be drunk at night, may do bad things at night, they enjoy their lust at night. We are the people of the light, of the day, not of the night. And even our nights will be sanctified by prayers, by serving God, by worshiping God. So we are enlightening the nights. We are making the nights and the light of the day because of our relationship with God. Let's who are of the day be sober, putting on the breastplate of faith and love. And that's, you know, a common example given by St. Paul to simplify the idea of the virtue of love and faith as keeping our heart in peace. When you have this breastplate that the soldiers were putting to, you know, to help them in their wars, you know, this breastplate will cover your heart. So no bad thoughts, bad emotions, bad ideas, nothing bad will come to your heart. You are saving your heart by peace and love. And as a helmet of hope of salvation, against he's focusing on the three pillars, faith, love, and hope. So he mentioned faith and love as a breastplate and the hope on the head, like a helmet of salvation. So when you have the hope in your mind and the love and faith in your heart, now you are empowered with God's grace. No one can attack you. You are powerful enough to conquer anyone, not to be, you know, conquered. For God did not appoint us to rest. The will of God is not, you know, the hell for anyone. The will of God is to have everyone with Him in heaven. The will of God is to save everyone through the knowledge of the real God, our Lord Jesus Christ. So, you know, putting this faith and hope and love in your mind and heart, now you are on the right track to not to go to the wrath of God. God did not appoint us to wrath, but to obtain salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ, who died for us, that whether we walk or sleep, we should live together with Him. Again, by walking or sleeping, it's not again the meaning of sleeping being in darkness like bad people. The meaning here is when you're still alive, you live with God. And when you die in Christ. So whether you are living or you falling asleep, with the second coming of Christ, you are waiting for Him and you are ready to start your kingdom of heaven with the Lord, who died for us that whether we walk or sleep, we should live together with Him. So we do not have a promise from Christ that we live forever here. All the believers, even the saints, will die one day, but they have the promise of eternal life. So we are not afraid of dying. We are not scared of death, but we are happy to live forever with Him after the day of resurrection. So we are waiting happily to see Christ by our eyes, not in this life, but in the coming life. Therefore, comfort each other. Again, he's saying the same word, because some of the people were very much anxious and sad because of the death of some of the believers in this city. Therefore, comfort each other and edify one another, just as you also are doing. So support each other and remind each other with the good news. Focus on the eternity coming and stay strong in hope, faith, and love. And we urge you, brethren, to recognize those who labor among you and are over you in the Lord and admonish you. So some of the good people were teaching the people, were supporting them. So we should recognize these people, because these people sent by God to support the church in times of affliction. We urge you, brethren, to recognize those who labor among you and are over you in the Lord and admonish you. So the teachers in the church, the fathers of the church, we should look up to them, respect them, and, you know, recognize them, because what they do is the great thing to be done in this world. And to esteem them very highly in love for their work's sake. Be at peace among yourselves. The respect and the honor given to the teachers of the church should be there always, because, you know, their work is very much esteemed. Now we exhort you, brethren, warn those who are unruly. Many people still living their life, but with no rules. Living a Christian life should have rules. And that's why when we pray, we commit ourselves to prayers, praying psalms, praying liturgies, praying Jesus' name. It's kind of a commitment. It's not like we are living unruly with God. We have rules. Rules of how to love God, rules of how to love people, rules of how to sanctify our life. So we have to warn those who are living with no rules. Comfort the faint-hearted. Many people are having weak hearts and their faith is very weak. So we need to comfort them, to support them. Uphold the weak. So the weak people needs to be strengthened. Be patient with all. All people needs, you know, this patience. Because to grow in spirit, it's not like a story of a day or two. We need to support each other and to be patient with the beginners. So he said, warn those who are unruly, comfort the faint-hearted, uphold the weak, be patient with everyone. So he's stating many commandments, all about loving people around. See that no one renders evil for evil to anyone, but always pursue what is good both for yourself and for all. Avoid doing any evil to anyone. We don't have except love. So we share love with everyone. We express love by respecting the elders or the priests, by warning those who are unruly, by, you know, comforting those who are faint-hearted, by strengthening or helping the weak in their will. But in all aspects, we just love everyone and never hurt or do evil to anyone. Rejoice always. Pray without ceasing. In everything, give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. If you are following, he made like four commitments, four commandments related to the people living around. After saying that we should esteem the people who taught us, he said it, warning some people, comforting some, upholding the weak, and be patient, avoid doing any evil to anyone. That's, you know, concerning the relationships. But concerning your life, your heart, keep these three. Rejoice always, pray always, thank God always. So rejoice always, pray without ceasing, in everything give thanks. So that's the beauty of Christian life from the inside. The good Christian is living a life of praying, praising, and happiness and joyful life. So by continuous praying with the thanksgiving attitude, you feel like you are very happy and enjoying the joy of the Spirit. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. That's exactly the will of God. God wants all His followers to live happily, to live in peace, to live in praying attitude. Do not quench the Spirit. The Spirit is like a fire in the heart. Don't quench the Spirit. Do not despise prophecies. Respect all the sermons. Prophecies here means all the sermon, the teaching of the church. Test all things. Test meaning here that you should think thoroughly in whatever you know you are exposed to. Hold fast what is good. After testing things, you will see good things to be done, and you will see bad things to avoid. Abstain from not only the bad things, abstain from every form of evil. So if you doubt things, please stay away. You should stick only to the good side, the good things to do. So again, after focusing on the relationships full of love, and you live spiritually in peace, in love, in praising God, also be alert, be wise enough to choose what to do, not to do any evil, to avoid any bad thing, and to stick to the good things. Now may the God of peace Himself sanctify you completely. That's the last prayer given by St. Paul to these people. May your whole spirit, soul, and body be preserved blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. When you follow the word of God, when you keep yourself holy, you will be given the gift of the eternal life. God will complete what's lacking in your life. If you're still weak, He is strong. He will help you to be strong. He who calls you is faithful, who also will do it. So do your part, and Christ will do His part. Christ is always faithful. Now, how much you are faithful to Christ. So work hard on yourself and on your relationships, on your mission, and make sure that Christ is doing His part fully and completely and perfectly. Brethren, pray for us. Greet all the brethren with a holy kiss. I charge you by the Lord that this epistle be read to all the holy brethren. So he is asking for their prayer as he used to pray for them. And also after greeting them with the holy kiss, he wanted that this message be delivered to all the brethren in Macedonia and the nearby cities. May God give us all His blessing. Glory to God. Amen.